शुरू हो गया। ठीक है,
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर लेसन अबाउट ड्राइविंग ऑफ द फार्म। फार्म वी से दिस इज अ प्रोडक्शन यूनिट, व्हाट इट इज अ फार्म विच प्रोड्यूसेस आउटपुट बाय कंबाइनिंग द इनपुट्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड देन इट प्रोड्यूसेस आउटपुट। This is the end result of the production process in which inputs are combined by a farm with the help of a technology to produce output. Here the farm is incurring a cost. Cost means expenditures on the inputs which are involved in the production of goods. Whereas whenever the farm is able to sell out the product, it will be receiving the revenue. What it is? The revenue will be received by the firm after the sale of the product. If sale of the product is not made, then what happens? Revenue cannot be generated. It will remain into the stock of the firm, and firm will not be able to maximize its profit until unless all its output is sold in the market. Then all these expenditures will be covered. This is the risk of any entrepreneur, that it has to sell out the product in order to maximize the profit. So revenue means the receipts of the sellers after the sale of the output. What is the revenue? Revenue means, what is revenue? Means the receipts of the firm after the sale of the product. So whatever output is produced when it is sold, then firm will be able to earn the revenue. This is cost from the inputs. It is able to incur the cost, and here it is going to receive the revenue. So what is the profit? Profit means the gap between revenue and cost. When revenues are more than the cost of production, the firm will be able to earn profit. Now, how much profit a firm can earn? That is decided by the profit maximizing level of output. Suppose one firm is producing 1000 units. Do you think it will be able to maximize profit? It may not be. Because it is possible that profit maximizing level of output is below the 1000 units of output. Alright? So that is another point, which is the profit maximizing level of output. We'll be doing it later on. But right now I will be focusing on the revenue of the firm. Revenue means when the firm is selling the output, it is receiving money. That money is called revenue of the firm after the sale of the product. Now you might be knowing what is meant by the total revenue when you were studying price elasticity of demand. Do you remember? Total revenue can be calculated. This is what? Total revenue. TR. It can be calculated by multiplying price with the quantity sold. Suppose the price of the product is 50 rupees and 100 units are sold. How much is the revenue of the firm? 5000. So when price is multiplied by the quantity sold, that will be the revenue. In this class, what is the revenue? Whatever the fee you are paying, that is the revenue of our school. This is the fixed fee of each student. And how many number of students are enrolled? Multiply with them, then you will be able to collect the revenue of this class. So when price is multiplied by the quantity sold, that is called the revenue. Now if you remember, how revenue of a firm can be increased? This is the main, how it can be changed. You might be knowing the price elasticity of demand. When demand is elastic, by decreasing the price, revenue will be increased. In case of elastic demand, what is elastic demand? This is an elastic demand. And why is it elastic? Because of the presence of substitutes. So many substitutes are available. If any firm wants to increase its revenue more than the rival firms, what will it do? It will decrease the price and it will be able to sell more quantity. When price falls, total revenue increases in case of an elastic demand. So revenue can be increased for this type of product where more substitutes are available. So by decreasing price, revenues can be increased. Alright? On the other hand, if we say there is inelastic demand, what is inelastic demand? This is an inelastic demand, which is a necessity. How revenue of the firm can be increased? By increasing the price. Because here proportionate change in quantity demand will be lower than the proportionate change in the price of the product. Okay? So in case of necessities, what happens? The price will increase in order to increase the revenue. Price increases and total revenue will be increasing. So can you say this revenue of the firm can be changed due to the change in price and quantity? Sold at quantity demand. It depends upon the elasticity of the product, price elasticity of demand of a product, whether it is elastic or inelastic, then the firm will be able to increase the revenue by changing the price. If it is elastic, by decreasing price, revenues can be changed. And if it is inelastic, by increasing price, revenues can be increased. Alright? On the other hand, we can also say revenues can also be increased and decreased due to perfectly elastic and inelastic demands. How? When price is fixed, a fixed price shop, if you say this is fixed price shop, where demand is perfectly elastic, this is price of the product. Price is fixed now. How revenue can be increased? By selling more units. If firm is selling only 10 units at price 50, there will be 500 revenue. And if firm is able to sell 100 units, then there will be 5000 revenue. So now it depends upon the quantity sold. How many units are sold because price is fixed? Then revenue can be increasing. So majority of time you see when prices are fixed, by selling more units at the fixed prices, what happens? Firm will be able to increase more its revenue. And sometimes we have perfectly inelastic demand. Here, the consumers will be buying the same quantity of the product, whatever the price is there. You can say nowadays sugar prices are high at 100 rupees per kg. So what happens? A family which was using 5 kg of sugar in a month, if its price was 16 rupees, how much the expenditure of that family was? 300. Now prices are 100 rupees per kg. What happens? Revenue of the sugar sellers has increased from 300 to 500 now. So in case of perfectly inelastic demand curve, what happens? Now prices are increasing, then revenues will increase. Can I say total revenue can be changed due to changing price and keeping the quantity changed? Both are changing. Sometimes only price is changing and sometimes only quantity is changing. So in all the cases, revenues of the firms can be changed. It depends in which type of market firm is operating. According to those conditions, it will be adopting the strategies to change the revenues. Alright. Ab revenue mein to problem nahi aa rahi na aapko. Ye samajh mein aa gaya. So what is meant by revenue and how it can be changed, increased or decreased? On the basis of this revenue, we will be studying the market structures. Cost of every firm will remain, the same curves will be there. Cost curves will remain same for all the market structures. Total cost share will be same, variable cost share will not be changing, average cost share will not be changing. But due to the changes in revenue, you will be having different shares. When demand is downward sloping, when demand is fixed, when there is a kinked demand,
So revenues are changing. So on the basis of price setting ability of the firm, sometimes the firms are price setters, like the monopolist. Sometimes the firms are price takers. They are in perfect competition. So their revenues are changing. Alright? Then we will be studying the market structures. So keep it in mind, revenues are very important in order to study the complete theory of firm. Alright? Now I am going to tell you the different types of revenues. What are the different types of revenues? One type we said total revenue. Types of revenue. One is called total revenue, which we recently explained. This is total revenue. Second is called marginal revenue. Marginal means what? Additional or extra. Very good. Now, the third type of revenue is average revenue. Alright? These are the three revenues which are going to be analyzed in the theory of firm. You can also say the tax revenues of the government. They are the federal government or provincial government revenues, tariff revenues. Okay? So these can be the other forms of revenues related to public sector. But in case of theory of the firm, we are analyzing three revenues: total revenue, marginal revenue, and average. Total revenue I have explained right now. I will be going into detail according to the pricing strategy of the firm. What will be the shape of total revenue? First of all, total revenue I've just defined, this is the price multiplied by quantity sold. This is what? Price into quantity sold. In all the cases. Now, what is marginal revenue? Marginal means additional or extra. When an extra unit is sold, how much is the change in total revenue? How much is the additional revenue brought into the firm by the sale of an extra unit? That is called marginal revenue. So can I say, marginal revenue is called change in total revenue due to change in quantity. How total revenue is changing due to an additional unit sold? Maths of mathematics. Can I say this is a gradient of total revenue? Differentiation. If we are taking the differentiation of total revenue, that will be called the marginal revenue. And if you integrate, then you will get the total revenue. Alright? So here we say this is an additional revenue. Suppose its price is 50 rupees and 100 board markers are sold. How much is the revenue? 5000. If 101 marker is going to be sold, an extra marker is sold, how much revenue firm is getting? Again the 50 rupees. So when price is fixed, the marginal revenue will be equal to the price of the product. An extra unit is sold, then the extra unit sold will be bringing to the firm the same price as the previous units were sold. When price is fixed. Like its price is 50 rupees, that is fixed in the market. So marginal revenue will be equal to the price. Because whenever a firm is selling an extra unit, it is receiving the same price as the previous units were sold. Alright? So I will give you a table form of these things. First of all, I am defining them, then I will be drawing a table and the diagrams as well. Now, average revenue means what? This is per unit revenue. What it is? Average, wherever word average is used, that means per unit. If I say average product of labor, then it is per worker output. When I say average revenue, it is per unit revenue of the firm. Alright? So when we talk about average revenue, how to find the average value? Divide the total revenue by the total quantity sold. Okay? Now if we divide total revenue by the quantity sold, what it is? This is per unit revenue. If I say total revenue is equal to price into quantity divided by quantity sold, What is left over?
Price.
So average revenue always equal to the price of the product. Alright? See over here. What is the average revenue? That's equal to the price of the product. Very simple. We are doing the simple mathematics. Everyone can understand that whenever we divide total revenue by total quantity sold, that is called average revenue. And when we look here, total revenue equal to price into quantity divided by total quantity sold, we will get only the price of the product. Now I am going to go to numerics, I will be drawing the diagrams. अगर किसी को अभी इसमें से कोई चीज समझ में नहीं आई तो नाउ आई सेड देयर कैन बी टू टाइप्स ऑफ फर्म्स ईदर द प्राइस सेटर्स और प्राइस टेकर्स व्हाट डू यू मीन द प्राइस सेटर्स दे आर सेटिंग द प्राइस इन द मार्केट बाय देमसेल्फ दे हैव द मार्केट पावर लाइक अ सिंगल सेलर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी आवर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सप्लायर Whatever the price they are charging, what can we do? We cannot switch over to another company. There is no option available to us. We have to buy the same product from the single seller. So he is the price setter. And if there are many sellers in the market, no one has the power to set his own price. Rather, he has to accept whatever the price is present in the market. So first we take a price taker form. When price is fixed, what will be the shapes of revenues and how do we calculate the revenues? Okay. Now I say price is here, quantity is here, we have to find total revenue, marginal revenue and average revenue. Okay. Price is 50 for simplicity. First unit is sold, how much is the revenue? Multiply that, that is 50. Marginal revenue is not there because extra unit is not sold. And if we say 0 unit was sold, then this is the marginal revenue. Previously there was no unit, now extra unit is sold, this will be the marginal revenue. Now price remains 50, second unit is sold. How much is revenue? 100. How much additional revenue is there?
50.
How much is the change in revenue? The 50 rupees is equal to the price, which is said when price is fixed. Okay. Now the third unit is sold. How much is revenue? Additional revenue. When you say the fourth unit is sold, 200, again we have 50. Now find out the average revenue. Divide total revenue by the quantity. 50 by 1, 50 for the first unit, 100 by 2, 150 by 3. Is it equal to the price of the product? Maths does not tell a lie. It can be proved. Very easy. This simple maths हम तो वो नहीं कर रहे. Trigonometry तो नहीं हो रही यहाँ पे. यहाँ तो simple mathematics है. It is easy to prove that average revenue is equal to price. Now see what is happening with the diagrams. If I draw the diagrams, okay. Let me know what type of demand curve will be if price is fixed. I have just drawn.
Perfectly. Lovely.
Very right. Demand is perfectly elastic, no, not vertical. Quantity is not fixed, but price is fixed. This is the main difference. When audience are present, we can make the correction as well. If you are thinking something else, we can rectify it. And once audience are absent and I am teaching, so whatever I am teaching, you cannot ask me anything. You are understanding by your own self. Okay? Now see, price is fixed, the shape of the demand curve, if you remember these values, I am going to erase them. Now see over here, price is fixed, firm is a price taker, whatever the market price is present, firm has to accept it. It cannot set its own price because it is not facing a downward sloping demand curve. It is facing a perfectly elastic demand curve. This is the elastic demand curve and this is the price. Its elasticity is infinite. What does it mean? at this going price, the firm can sell as much as it can produce. Now it is its production capacity, how much it can produce. There is infinite demand. But each firm is a tiny part of the whole market. Smaller part. It cannot influence in the market. It cannot supply all the demand of the product. I can give you an example. There are so many rice producers in the rice market. Can any single farmer can influence the price? There is infinite demand of rice in Pakistan or around the globe. None of the seller can sell by his own price. Whatever the market price is there, he has to accept it. Alright? So demand is perfect. A single seller cannot fulfill the infinite demand of all the market. He is a small part of the total market. Now you see, price is fixed. I said, what will be the shape of total revenue in this case? If I write over total revenue, at 0 unit, total revenue was 0. When more units were sold, what happened? This is the shape of total revenue. You might have studied in your O level. This is the shape of total revenue curve. Is it constant slope?
Yes.
It is constantly slope. Okay, can I say what is the slope of this total revenue? Change in total revenue due to change in quantity, which is the margin revenue. Slope of this total revenue curve will be the margin revenue. If I draw the margin revenue curve over here, this is the shape of margin revenue. At 50, here I should write the margin revenue. So marginal revenue is also equal to 50. It is also having a horizontal line. That is the demand curve. Because it's equal to the price. And what will be the shape of average revenue? That's also 50. As I said, it's equal to the price. How to find average revenue from this curve? Can you find? This is what? At this point, this is total revenue, this is the quantity, total output. Divide this distance with this one.
We get price.
Again, we will be getting the price. Anyhow, these three curves are the same shape. Can I say, when a firm is price taker, its price is equal to average revenue and it's equal to the marginal revenue of the firm. So if we draw all these three curves in one diagram, they all will be overlapping to each other. Suppose I draw over here, okay, this is the 50, okay. I write over here rupees on the vertical side, because now everything is measured, average revenue, margin revenue and price, they are all measured on this vertical axis. Now if I draw the demand curve, this is the line. If I draw the average revenue, it will be overlapped by the demand curve. And if I draw the marginal revenue in the same diagram, that will also be overlapping the same thing. So three curves will be overlapped to each other when price is fixed. At fixed price market, at fixed price seller, what happens? Price equals to average revenue, but it is also equal to marginal revenue. When total revenue is having this shape. Now see, Azima, you can say how this revenue can be increased or decreased other than at the same price, this is a straight line upward slope. If price has increased, like price is now 60, so your total revenue will have this time. It becomes cheaper. Alright? When a seller cannot himself change the price, when market price has increased, then the shape of total revenue becomes cheaper. And when price goes to 40, it will be like this. So what I said, that when we have a straight line demand curve, so straight line total revenue, or perfectly elastic demand curve, a firm is a price taker, then we have this shape of the total revenue, which is upward sloping and constantly sloped. Its slope is not varying at any point, which is called the marginal revenue. And when we draw the marginal revenue, this is also equal to the demand curve or the price of the product. And when we draw the average revenue, that's also equal to the price of the product. Then the three curves will be overlapping to each other. क्योंकि यहाँ तक कोई पॉइंट आपको समझ में ना आया हो, then you can ask me, because I will go to the price setter firm, in which a normal demand curve which is downward sloping, when firm is facing that demand curve, so how revenues will be changing? What will be the shapes of these revenues? Can they Okay, it cannot be concluded if I start now. We will be doing our shapes of revenues when we are having changing price, like the demand curve is downward sloping. This is that I did it in my AS level, if you remember, while I was teaching you price elasticity of demand. The same thing I will be repeating in my next class. And by tomorrow, I will also be telling you where the firm will be able to maximize the profit. Come up tomorrow by revising, after revising your cost of production topic. Because I will be using marginal cost and marginal revenues in the same diagram to show you where revenue of the firm, where the profit of the firm will be maximized. I will be using differentiation as well. Because slope of total cost is called marginal cost. Slope of any total curve, if you say total utility, its slope will be called marginal utility. Slope of total physical product will become marginal product. Slope of total revenue is called marginal revenue. And slope of total cost is called marginal cost. Where marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue, where both slopes are equal, that is the profit maximizing level. I will show it tomorrow. First, I will be doing the things related to price setter firm, revenues, its shapes, and then I will be doing the profit maximizing by tomorrow, inshallah. I think tomorrow is Thursday.
Yes.
It'll be happening the same timing for the class. Okay. So come up after revising your cost of production, and then we will be going ahead. Thank you. That's all for